That orbital insertion burn was scheduled to take place 31 minutes after launch, but didn't happen on schedule.
Boeing Starliner spaceship was sent back to the factory in August. NASA had planned to launch the Starliner for a crewless test flight to the ISS or International Space Station this past summer, but the space agency and Boeing postponed the mission after a valve issue was discovered on the vehicle before launch.
Boeing executives had talked about this flight as one of great importance for the company, and staff had spent months working through every issue from the first flight.
Challenges with space technology or vehicles aren't uncommon. Both Boeing's Starliner project and its competitor, SpaceX's Dragon Crew capsule, have been delayed multiple times. But how did Boeing, a company with such a long history at the cutting edge of the space industry, suffer so many setbacks?
5, 4, 3, 2.
Since the height of the Cold War, Boeing's name has been synonymous with ambitious American space endeavors.
Some of its biggest accomplishments include vehicles for the Apollo program, which sent humans to the moon.
In 2014, NASA contracted two companies, SpaceX and Boeing, to create two different space vehicles that would serve as the next generation of spaceships to transport crew to the ISS.
SpaceX had been around for a little more than a decade. It was still a relatively young company, still building out its operations and technology, whereas Boeing had, you know, been working with NASA for decades.
Since the space shuttle's retirement in 2011 and until 2020, the U.S. did not have the capability to transport crew to orbit.
And liftoff.
For about a decade, NASA relied on Russia's Soyuz rocket to get American crews to the ISS.
Boeing Starliner was designed to take astronauts to the International Space Station and get them home. Boeing's is attached on top of a rocket, which separates after that initial launch. It's meant to travel and dock with the space station.
And liftoff, the rise of Starliner and a new era in human spaceflight.
In 2019, Boeing and NASA attempted to send an uncrewed Starliner to the ISS with much fanfare.
Now passing 1 minute into flight.
But that test flight failed due to two programming errors. The spacecraft's internal timer was off by 11 hours, stranding it in the wrong orbit and preventing it from reaching the International Space Station. Boeing CST-100 Starliner capsule did, however, return to Earth safely.
So we did have, obviously, some challenges today. When the spacecraft separated from the launch vehicle, we did not get the orbital insertion burn that we were hoping for.
Another potentially catastrophic error was fixed during the mission.
One error sent the Starliner to the wrong orbit, and then the second involved software that controls thrusters that help angle the craft to avoid damaging a heat shield, which protects the vehicle during re-entry. Software emerged after the flight failed as a sort of a major issue that Boeing needed to address for a future attempt.
After the flight, NASA's leadership was concerned that Boeing had a broader cultural problem in light of the 737 MAX crisis, which involved two fatal crashes in Indonesia and Ethiopia. The agency ordered a sweeping outside review, resulting in dozens of recommendations.
The failure of the 2019 Starliner test mission was a big deal for Boeing. Boeing was still grappling with the fallout from the 737 MAX crisis. A successful Starliner mission was seen as a way to help restore its reputation for reliability and engineering prowess.
In December 2019, Boeing's board, already frustrated by the MAX crisis, ousted Boeing's CEO, Dennis Muhlenberg. Then in August, Boeing and the space agency said they would again postpone the redo of the test mission because some valves on the Starliner's propulsion system became stuck before launch. NASA declined to comment last week. The agency said earlier in October that it and Boeing were making progress investigating the Starliner's valves. In a statement, Boeing said it is focused on supporting our NASA customer and the path forward will be driven by safety and thorough testing. We have full confidence in our ability to deliver Starliner for its ultimate mission. NASA said the vehicle won't launch again this year. The space agency also shifted two astronauts who had been assigned to fly on Starliner missions to a future SpaceX flight.
NASA said it was shifting these astronauts because it needed to ensure that those astronauts were getting space experience, and it wanted to give Boeing time to develop the Starliner.
These most recent Starliner setbacks come at a challenging time for Boeing's business. After making record revenue in 2018, Boeing has lost nearly half that amount, largely due to a sharp drop in commercial aircraft deliveries and MAX-related charges. Today, the company is more reliant on its space business than it was in the past. Boeing's space program is a key part of its defense, space, and security unit.
Boeing generated more than $6 billion in revenue from space-related work last year, and that accounted for a little more than 10% of, you know, all of the company's revenue for that year.
To date, Boeing's Starliner development has cost $3.2 billion, while SpaceX's Dragon has cost far less at $2.6 billion. What's more, unlike Boeing, SpaceX has managed to get crewed missions into space.
There's the crew on the right-hand side of your screen. I think I see some more thumbs up there.